to St. Paul's Cathedral in San Diego and our virtual worship community. My name is Penny Bridges, and as Dean, it's my joy to welcome you, whoever you are and wherever you find yourself in the journey of faith. Today is Cathedral Day, our annual observance of our patron saint and the day of our annual parish meeting. A special welcome to you if you found us online or have come across us during the pandemic. Our online activities are well established now and will continue indefinitely. We're so glad that you found us. Please use the comments on Facebook Live or YouTube to tell us about celebrations and prayer requests, or to ask a question about the service, or just to say hello. It's our habit to say a prayer for anyone celebrating a birthday or an anniversary this week. And especially I want to remember Adele Moore, who will turn 90 tomorrow, January 25th. Let us pray. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall. And in their hearts may your peace, which passes understanding, abide all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. This service was previously recorded and portions of it come from our video archive. I'll just remind you of our weekday worship offerings, daily morning and evening prayer on Zoom and Spanish Compline on Wednesdays on Facebook. Our Friday fellowship is every Friday at 5:30 p.m., a chance to catch up with your cathedral friends. And now let us gather to worship.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble before him.
O Lord, open thou our lips.
O Lord, open thou our lips.
praise ye the Lord.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Awake, awake, put on strength, O arm of the Lord. Awake as in days of old, the generations of long ago. Was it not you who cut Rahab in pieces, who pierced the dragon? Was it not you who dried up the sea, the waters of the great deep, who made the depths of the sea a way for the redeemed to cross over? So the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. I am he who comforts you. Why then are you afraid of a mere mortal who must die, a human being who fades like grass? You have forgotten the Lord your Maker, who stretched out the heavens and laid the foundations of the earth. You fear continually all day long because of the fury of the oppressor who is bent on destruction. But where is the fury of the oppressor? The oppressed shall speedily be released. They shall not die and go down to the pit, nor shall they lack bread. For I am the Lord your God, who stirs up the sea so that its waves roar. The Lord of hosts is his name. I have put my words in your mouth and hidden you in the shadow of my hand, stretching out the heavens and laying the foundations of the earth, and saying to Zion, you are my people. Here ends the reading. reading from Paul's letter to the Galatians. For you were called to freedom, brothers and sisters. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for self-indulgence, but through love become slaves to one another. For the whole law is summed up in a single commandment. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. If, however, you bite and devour one another, take care that you are not consumed by one another. Live by the Spirit, I say, and do not gratify the desires of the flesh. For what the flesh desires is opposed to the Spirit, and what the Spirit desires is opposed to the flesh. For these are opposed to each other to prevent you from doing what you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not subject to the law. Now the works of the flesh are obvious: fornication, impurity, licentiousness, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, anger, quarrels, dissensions, factions, envy, drunkenness, carousing, and things like these. I'm warning you, as I warned you before, those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. By contrast, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There's no law against such things. And those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also be guided by the Spirit. Here ends the reading.
Righteousness. Of thy people, and in our time grant us thy peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments,
and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of all enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness. Through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give thine angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for thy love's sake.
On this, our Cathedral Day, I bid your prayers for the church and for this cathedral community. Gracious Father, we pray for thy holy Catholic Church. Fill it with all truth, in all truth with all peace. Where it is corrupt, purify it. Where it is in error, direct it. Where in anything it is amiss, reform it. Where it is right, strengthen it. Where it is in want, provide for it. Where it is divided, reunite it. For the sake of Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Savior. Amen. O God, our Heavenly Father, bestow upon this cathedral family and clergy who minister your word and sacraments the rich blessings of thy loving kindness, that we may prove ourselves a people mindful of thy favor and glad to do thy will. Make us alive to the opportunities and responsibilities of our times, and save us from complacency and from fear of new ways. Keep us open to all who need our love and fellowship, and inspire us with a vision to do thy will. For the sake of our Savior, Jesus Christ, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen.